Well, good Wednesday morning to you folks. Hopefully things are going well with you. You had a good night's rest and you're ready to face the day, whatever that holds for you. I'm going to read to you from the book of Luke today in chapter 16 of the book of Luke, something you no doubt have heard many times. Just going to read a portion of this. There was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried, and in hell he lift up his eyes, being in torment, and seeth Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. I'm just going to stop there. If you've never heard that story, Luke chapter 16. Jesus doesn't say this is a parable. He says there was a certain rich man. So my thought process would be that this is someone that Jesus knew exactly the situation, and he brought it forth for these people to hear. This man was laid every day. Every day he was there at that rich man's gate, just begging for food to eat. And the dogs had more compassion than this rich man. Now, my subject this morning isn't riches. It isn't being a rich man. It isn't even going to hell. But my subject this morning is, my thought is, the angels came when that beggar died and carried him to heaven. Now, I know there are a lot of people say, well, my thought is this, or my belief is this, and if you can't find those things in the Bible, it's hard to back those things up. I mean, you know, you could believe just about anything you choose to believe, but it needs to be based in truth, not in just your thought or what makes you feel good. It's been, today is the anniversary of a friend of mine who was a World War II veteran there in Conway, South Carolina, that had passed away. And this is the anniversary of his death. He said to me one time, I was in his home visiting with him, and I would sing him songs. And I sang this song that I'm going to sing for you here. I've sang it on here before, and I probably told this story, but on the 26th day of October in 2015, Mr. Harry Basher said, "Will you sing that for me at my funeral?" He asked me then, and it was within the next couple of years that I would be singing it at his service. But this song says, "Come, angel band, and carry me away." Now, you may believe that or you may not. The scripture verifies that for this rich man, the angels came and carried him to Abraham's bosom. You think whatever you want to. I talked with someone the other day, and when it comes right down to it, we're going to think what we choose. We're going to believe what we choose. If you believe in God, if you don't believe in God, there's nothing I can do probably to convince you. It will be the Holy Spirit doing that. But just give a thought to what would happen if you were to pass. And I'm in the room with folks when they pass. A lot of times I've been by the bedside of people that have passed. And my thought has always been, I wonder what the first thing they see is. We'll never know. I'll share with you, but there was a little woman who said one time, her daughter said, "Now, Mom, remember the psychologist from the hospital's coming today." And the mother said, "Why is he coming?" She said, "He's coming to talk to you about death." And the little woman looked at me, and she looked back at her daughter, and she said, "Call him back and tell him not to come. He ain't never done it. He don't know how it feels." Which I thought was kind of funny, but it is the truth. We've never done it. We don't know how it feels. We don't know what it will be like. But reading the angels carried him to Abraham's bosom gives me comfort to believe that those same angels, if God's no respect, a person can come and take you and me and Mr. Harry as well. So I'll go ahead and sing this in memory of him. My latest sun is sinking fast. My race is nearly run. My strongest trials now are past. My triumph is begun. Oh, come, angel band, come and around me stand. Oh, bear me on your snowy wings to my immortal home. Oh, bear me away on your snowy wings to my immortal home. I've almost gained my heavenly home. My spirit loudly sings. The holy ones, behold, they come. I hear the noise of wings. Oh, come, angel band, come and around me stand. Oh, bear snowy wings to my immortal home. Oh, bear me away on your snowy wings to my immortal home. Oh, bear my longing heart to him who bled and died for me, whose blood now cleanses from all sin and gives me victory. Oh, come, angel band, come and around me stand. Oh, bear me away on your snowy wings to my immortal home. Oh, bear me away on your snowy wings to my immortal home. Lord, as we come to you, we do thank you for the day you've given us, Lord, and we thank you for the hope of being where you are one day when we leave this world. And sometimes this world here, this life, what we experience isn't bad. Sometimes it's really bad. But God, when we leave here to be in your presence, to be where you are, to be there because of your Son, whether it is that we are carried away by angels or you come and get us yourself, however it is, we'll be content because we will be where you are. We love you, Lord, and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, folks. I was thinking before I turn this off of the folks that every once in a while mention that they watch this and that they listen to it. That's good, and I'm glad that you do. I wouldn't be doing it if you weren't watching it, and I'm not. No doubt, I'm not doing it for my health, but I'm doing it trying to encourage someone. But please do encourage others that you come in contact with today as well. I pray that if you're being lifted up, not by this, but by anything, that you will take the time out of your day give strength and give help and give guidance to those folks you come in contact with. We all have seed to sow. We all have a job to do. We all have work to do. And my prayer is that you are doing just that. God bless you, and I'll see you Thursday.